Hello everybody and welcome back to Aurora 4X. I of course am Sir Bedian, and today we are going to smash ourselves some precursor ships. We already have one knocked out, a Vanguard class 15,400 tons knocked out by a very lovely missile salvo. We have the Hood, which is now appears to be in retreat, currently being chased down by Hunt Group Alpha. Number two, which consists of our Wyvern class frigates. So we've got those in pursuit at the moment. They're about an hour out, according to the indicator here. Although I think they might not. Oh, we do have missiles. Oh, okay. Size one missiles. Now, we do have point defense fire, but I don't think we have that much point defense fire. So, what we're going to do, Hunt Group Alpha 2, we are actually going to reverse course. And from the Hood, which appears to be our point defense ship. Or an anti-missile ship, sorry. Clockwise, there we go. This will make them take immediate action. Let's see how fast they're going. 30,000. Yeah, that's going to be a problem. Group Alpha 2. Yeah, so they're definitely going to catch us. This is going to be interesting. There seems to be quite a lot of anti-missile missiles in here. They are size 6 salvos, so it might be possible that, like, there's only 6 of them per salvo. And we do have 3 with advanced railguns. There is a significant chance that we might be able to actually have the point defense systems to handle this. 6 missiles, we got 45 shots per ship, and maybe about 33% accuracy. So we're gonna withdraw just to make sure they don't hit us at the exact same time. But yeah. We are going to hope that we do have the point defense capability. Now, the Wyverns do also have, 8-9 layers of armor? It's 8, isn't it? 7. Okay, so they have 7 layers of armor and 32 columns. So, it is entirely possible that even if we can't shoot them down, we will be able to just tank them. Let's just do a 30-second jump real quick. Or not, because we're still detecting incoming missiles. That is a lot of anti-missile missiles. Any more new ones? Yep, plenty of new ones. Okay, so we've got about 9,000 tracking speed. They've got 26, 9, 18, 24, no, 27... Yeah, so we've got about a 33% accuracy at the moment. Here we go. Almost, and how are we doing? 4 weapons fire, 6 missiles destroyed. The other issue, of course, is that we can't fire immediately. Fire rate is about 10 seconds. Okay. It's actually not too bad. But the withdrawal? Ugh, really? Why? Freaking ridiculous. And why did the first one not trigger the point defense? Freaking bullshit. No current record. It's gotta be from like overkilling or something. Yeah, like zero weapons fired, zero missile destroyed. What the shit is up with that? Yeah, see, that one didn't trigger. But that one did. Yeah, it's... it's gotta be the targeting of the point defense. It's gotta be. See, zero weapons fired, zero missile destroyed. That one didn't. Alright, which one of you bosses is actually firing zero guns? Amazon. Okay, fine. At least I think that might be the last of it. 2564. Yeah, that's the last of it. So we don't have too much to suffer through. Okay, so I've just made some quick adjustments. I've gone to have a look and I've just made some quick adjustments that hopefully will stop the error from happening. And if that's the case, I'll explain. If it stops it, I'll explain why. Okay, I guess it doesn't. It's got to be something about these fire controls trying to fire on, trying to defend the fleet. I mean, there is also the option where, not really. It's a little bit on the wasteful side to try and use it. Oh, that's a fire. And we could run self-only. Self-only does not have this issue, apparently. But I am concerned... Actually, you know what? Let's do some science. I'm going to set these to the final to self-only. And we'll see if this only protects the ship, or if it protects only the single individual task group. Let's find out. It's only 6 missiles, so it's not like... Okay, so it's definitely the cacti that are doing it. Okay. Protects only the ship. Cool. So, final defensive fire. Set. Copy. Good. Cactus. None. None. Now we'll see if it works. Amazon takes 1 point of damage. Yeah, that's not even worth mentioning. It's still doing it. What the shit? Come on! Nobody's trying to fire except the guys who are actually in fucking range! Okay. New thing. Anyone who is not in system who happens to be running point defense mode. Gonna get to the bottom of this. Guarantee it. Not more cacti. Turn off all PD everywhere. Okay. No PD anywhere. The only ones who are running final fire are these three. Oh, they actually took another hit. Okay, it looks like that's done it. Ah! Finally, no more error bullshit. Ooh, 3 hits on Amazon. That's fine. I will accept 0.03% crew grade bonus. Okay. Hunt group Alpha 2. Turn around. Chase down that hood. get the bastard. Right, so best as I can gather, the issue was that some ship somewhere was trying to protect these guys from missiles. Now, how it could do that from something like four systems over, I don't know. But obviously, something somewhere in the point defense assignment was confused, and it was trying to shoot down missiles that were in a completely different system. Hence, the errors. Because, you know, you're not supposed to be able to shoot down missiles in a completely different system. Doesn't make sense. It's ridiculous. It's silly. Alright. Hunt Group Alpha 2 is closing in fast. Not that fast. It's only twice the speed of the Hood. Beaufort is directly behind it to provide surveillance. Zoom in a little bit. There we go. Almost there. Oh, he's turned around. He is rapidly approaching range. So, weapons lock on the Hood. Copy target. Now, what we're going to do is we are going to clear weapon assignment. And we are going to open fire on the actual fire controls. Now, it's got a chance of hitting, but it's not actually firing anything, so it's okay. Oh, he's turned around, has he? Is there a chance to hit ECM of 40 strength? Do we actually have any ECCM on our Wyverns? I believe we do not. This is going to be a problem. Because this means that we do have a 40% chance, a reduction of 40% to our hit chance once we do actually open fire. We're basically really going to have to get on top of it to actually do anything to it. But that's okay. That is A-okay. Because we want to get directly on top of it. Alright. Oh, we got their active sensor contact. That'll be its resolution 1 sensor, 2.something million? Yeah, it's not a very strong one. Alright, so we are within fire control range. So we're 20% modified by E-War down to 0. So that's going to modify down from 40 up to 40%. So if we go a little bit closer, you can see it's up at 31, but it's still modified down to 0. We're definitely going to have to get some ECCM on these. Okay, so now they finally have a base chance, have a chance to hit above 0. But you can see that without the E-War, we would already be firing because we would have a 50% chance. 50-50, I'm okay with. I'm okay with taking a 50-50 shot. But at the moment, we're only at 10. So, but, you know, that's going to jump up really fast. So we can probably start allocating the railguns now. Because they fire fast enough as it is. Off you go. Railguns away. Chunker, 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 chunker. multiple hits, only one damage, but not only, so only really glancing hits, but definitely some nice solid impacts. Barely solid. Hardly solid. But impacts nonetheless. 23% chance. I think we'll switch to... Yeah, 40%. Let's wait once more. See how the railguns fare. Oof, that's some nice damage. Multiple hits. Armor strength is of at least 2. There we are. That is a lot of hits. We got a 51% chance to hit. Between fire control, crew grade, and E-War. So, not too shabby. So, now that we've worn down, that reminds me. We didn't actually show the... The combat results. That's unfortunate. Okay, but let's go have a look at this guy. So, precursors. Which one of these is going to be it? Let's have a look at armor status. Here we go. This is the one. So you can see that our railguns have peppered some pretty significant damage. This will be one of those one damage hits here. Damage seems to be concentrated in these sections of the ship. It's not really... It is kind of random, but it's not really truly random. And we can see that we've basically only really damaged the armor, right? So we haven't actually damaged any of its internals. But now that we have some pretty big holes in the armor, now is the perfect time to start hitting it with the lasers. And we have some pretty damn nice lasers. So, let's go ahead and rig the lasers for active. Fire the laser! And let's see what happens from their perspective. Well, there's that. So, 3 hits of 24 damage. Now, a 24 damage laser has 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. It pretty much would have punched right through this anyway, if I'm correct. Yeah. Because 9 damage laser has 5 layers of penetration, I believe. And this is like 6. And that's a 24 damage laser. Now, I'm not going to toggle this because it will complain if I do. So I'm just going to close this and reopen it. Actually, there's not really much point. There's nothing to see. But if we go have a look and we'll switch event logs. So, we can see here. Let's actually focus in. So from our perspective, target hit. 24 damage impact impact detected. Of course, it's ours. Target hit and target hit. And destroyed. Fairly straightforward. Let's have a look at it from their perspective. So from their perspective, 3 hits detected because they just took damage. So... Oh, they called our Wyvern class Doombringer. Oh, how appropriate. I like it. So you can see here, 18 damage absorbed by armor out of 24. Now, I can't remember if I actually talked about the exact, exactly how Aurora damage works. So if I have, skip ahead. If I haven't, then here it is. Okay, so... First things first, it determines if you have shields, it'll absorb the damage off shields. If you don't, it'll absorb it off armor. So it determines where it's hit, and then it determines the penetration, and then it shaves off any armor absorption. After that, it will roll on the damage allocation chart. And if we go have a look, I'm just going to use this one as an example. So it'll roll on the damage allocation chart, and pick a component. So you can see here that the first component that it landed on is the military jump drive. Military jump drive only has 3 hit to kill. Actually, I will switch to the correct actual design. What is it? It's Missile Guardian J. Is that it? Yeah, I believe that's it. Yeah, that's it. Okay. So if we have a look at the DAC here, all right, you can see here that out of 137, the military jump drive is 16 points. All right, so landed on here, selected the military jump drive. Military jump drive has 3 hit to kill, so one component, 3 hit to kill. 3 of our remaining damage, so 24 minus 18, is 6. So half of the damage went into destroying the jump drive. When the jump drive destroyed, the crew count of that jump drive has been was subtracted from the ship. 3 damage was left over, and the magazine hit to kill 3 has 3 hit to kill, so it rolled again, picked a magazine, and then allocated 3 points of damage, destroying it. Fairly straightforward. So 2 3 hit to kill components were hit by 6 damage. 3 damage was allocated to one, 3 damage was allocated to the other. It perfectly enough to completely destroy both components. That's the first hit. Second hit. Crew grade goes up, as it always does. 21 damage absorbed by armor. So it looks like these two mostly hit in the intact areas of the ship. 21 damage absorbed by armor. So 3 damage added to the internal pool. Then it also dealt 7 additional internal damage due to shock damage. So this is why you want hits to be doing 20, 30, 40 plus damage, so that you get additional damage, right? So this hit was not really a 24 hit. It was a 24 hit for penetration, but for in terms of damage, this ended up an extra 7 damage on top. So that would make it a 31 damage hit. So you definitely want this. And what's really good is that the 7 damage of shock actually gets added to any penetrating damage pool. So instead of being 1 damage, and you can't really see it here because the first roll was a 1 damage point anyway, but this actually is an 8 damage hit in terms of damage calculation. Anyway, so we got an 8 damage pool, 1 point engine, 5 hit to kill, rolled up next, absorbed 5 damage, and was destroyed, 3 casualties. That leaves us with 3 damage in the pool. Site missile launcher receives 0 points of damage. What's really interesting is that this doesn't actually absorb any damage out of the pool, right? So we have 3 points of damage. You can see that we still destroyed 3 1 hit to kill components, right? So 0 hit to kill components are really, really bad for ship survivability, because 1 point of damage can chew through like all of your 0 hit to kill components at once, right? They absorb 0 points of damage. If they get rolled, they die, the damage keeps rolling. So 0 hit to kill components are really bad for ship survivability, but sometimes you have to deal with them. So this Aurora missile launcher, 3 damage, 0 absorbed, 3 damage left. Fuel storage absorbed 1. ECM-4, destroyed 2. Crew quarters absorbed the 3rd. Here's where it gets interesting. Another engine got knocked out. Did I do the math wrong? I did do the math wrong. There's 10. No. 21 absorbed by armor leaves 3. Yeah, so there was 10 damage left. So 10 total, 5 absorbed, 5 left, 4, 5 left, 4, 3, 2, 1. And this is a pretty bad roll for him, because so engine has 5 hit to kill, and we destroyed it on 1. So we rolled a 20% roll, which is pretty impressive. So that was just really bad luck on his behalf. They've lost the engine on that first hit. and that slowed down his speed. Now, you'll notice that the speed, right, let's switch back to us real quick. So you'll see here that base chance to hit, which is based on speed. No, it's a fire control to hit 94, 94, 94. Modified by crew grade, modified by EWAR, right? None of these had a speed penalty, and that's mainly because we have twice the tracking speed, so no speed penalty there. But what you'll also, what you should be paying attention to is modified by EWAR, right? Because if you remember, the second, so it wasn't the ECM was destroyed here in the second hit, not the third, not the first, the second hit. So accuracy is rolled, all the accuracy for all the weapons is rolled at the same time, and then damage is allocated, right? Otherwise, at least one of these should not have been modified by EWAR, right? Because the ECM was destroyed by the second hit, which means that the third hit should not have been modified by EWAR if they're allocated sequentially. So accuracy is determined initially, and then all damage is allocated. That is that is very important information to know when you are considering EWAR, speed reduction, and all of that jazz. Right, so that means that even if we didn't have the tracking speed, the engine damage that caused it to slow down will not have improved shots, subsequent shots from any additional weapons. Right, so we just knocked out the engine. Third hit, 11 points of damage absorbed by armor out of 24, plus 7 shock damage, which is just terrible for him. 24 minus 11 is 13, plus 7 is 20. So that's 20 damage rolling through the ship. Fuel storage destroyed. Absorb 1, 19. Missile launcher absorbed 0. Magazine absorbed 3, so that's 4 absorbed so far. Missile launcher, none. Fuel storage, 1. ECCM destroyed. Engine destroyed. Secondary explosion inflicted 19 further damage. That's a whole extra pool. I don't think that actually... I'm not sure if that actually affected it and it actually rolled. Because I'm not sure if the secondary explosions roll after the primary weapon hit. But yeah, with 20 damage on the block, it really didn't stand a chance. It had 66 hit to kill total, right? 66 hit to kill, is it 66 hit to kill total? It took 6 plus 3, that's 9, plus 7 is 26, and then another 20, that's 46, and then a further 19 off the secondary explosion. So that's 46, 55, 65. So, yeah. At best, it would have had one hit to kill left on this ship. One. So, even if this hadn't destroyed it, it would have been gutted. But, let's actually tally up real quick what components were destroyed. So, first hit knocked out the jump drive, alright? So, we can knock out the jump drive. Let's count the engines. No, not you. Engine... Actually, let's have a quick look. So, what you might notice, if you have a look real quick, right, is that the bridge was never actually destroyed. So that one hit to kill left before it was destroyed would have been the bridge, but I don't think it actually survived. Took 65 hit to kill worth of damage, right? So the EM sensor was also not destroyed. If you have a look, the EM sensor wasn't destroyed. The fire control, I believe, was not destroyed as well. Oh no, the active sensor did get destroyed, and the fire control did get destroyed. Okay. So most of the stuff got destroyed, but it does have, but the EM sensor didn't get destroyed, right? So, and this is because of the way that it rolls. So it would have, so at this point, so after this crew quarters were destroyed, it re-rolled again because it had damage left over, and it hit a component that where everything's been wiped out. So it re-rolls, and it hit the component where everything's been wiped out. Now, it's done this most likely a couple of times, especially around here at the end, right? But each time, it was able to land on a component within 20 rerolls until this crew quarters was destroyed. The next point of damage, or the next roll, could not find a component on the DAC that still had a component in the category within 20 rerolls. At that point, when it hit that 20th roll, structural failure, ship destroyed. And that's it. Simple as that. Yeah, okay, it's not exactly simple. But it is reasonably straightforward once you understand it. And that is why, once we salvage this ship, we are going to get ourselves an EM detection sensor. We're not going to get the bridge, because you don't salvage a bridge. But that EM detection sensor, and that thermal sensor as well, we're going to get those passive sensors once we actually salvage this. Keep that in mind. Keep an eye out for it. I'll probably forget by the time we get a salvage ship in here. But keep an eye out for it. When we salvage this, you'll notice that we get the passive sensors out of it. Okay. I've talked enough. Designer mode off. Space Master off. Let's continue with our charge. Whoa, what are these guys? Oh, right, that's us. whoops. Okay. Alright, so we knocked them out, and yeah, you can see here, secondary power system explosion, strength 19, that helped knock them out. So, hood has been destroyed. And, funnily enough, hood destroyed by a secondary power system explosion. So, classic! Next on the chopping block, the Dukes of York. Contact, Duke of York 2. Fellow. Beaufort, we are going to run Duke of York 2. Actually, quick thing. Yeah, no. Okay, Duke of York 2. Okay. Let's continue on. We are going to actually have to tell them to hold fire real quick because they lost targets. Clear fleets. Okay. Let us carry on. Advancing onwards on the Dukes of York. Where are they? What are they doing at the moment? Okay, so we're carrying on. Now, that's about 2 hours away, so I'm going to do 20-minute ticks. But I'm going to do 2 minutes cycles maximum. Just so we don't get caught out. Now, I believe Dukes of York are probably going to be missile boats. I'm fairly confident the Dukes of York are missile boats. Actually, no. I think Amazons are going to be the missile boats. Dukes of York might be gunboats. But we'll find out soon enough. Closing in, nice and quick. That Chatham is 15 kilotons. We got 714. We're about even with the Chatham. We got thermal signature of 640 on the Dukes of York. Alpha 2 is closing in rapidly. They're going to be within range 45 minutes. Bit longer because they're actually running away, but whatever. We are closing in. We are going to have the issue of the ECM again because we are lacking in our E-War suite, which we do need to do something about. I think I will upgrade the Wyverns with E-War after this because it's like they just need it. Res 1 sensor. So I believe these guys were firing the anti-lack missiles at us. The ones that were just coming in trickles and waves. So Dukes of York, I'm fairly confident the missile boats. So we should not have too much trouble with this. Alright, we are approaching rapidly. Lock target onto Duke of York 1. Clear. Weapon assignment. Open fire. Good. We are less than... maybe a minute out. Couple minutes out, tops. We should be almost within weapon range. Yep, there we go. Hit chance is... Actually, let's just lock camera real quick. Now, we have accuracy just within the range of our actual railguns. So, we're at 7% now. 22. Okay, if they haven't fired now, I think it's safe enough to just close to point blank and just blast them with the lasers. Well, blast them with everything for them while we're at it. That'll do. Assign all to Duke of York. Okay, assign all to Duke of York. Opening fire and bang. That hurts. Okay. End weapon impact 24-24-333. That's a dead Duke of York. Alright. Ship has been destroyed. Switch target to Duke of York 2. Recharge and open fire. This is why you always aim at the ship that you're not following. Get escort location. Okay, somebody is being a bit weird. Bang! That's our railguns firing. Lasers should be coming up right about now. Almost. I think we knocked out its engines. Really interesting, though. That one had Steve's email. Don't know if I need to censor that or not. Okay, hang on. Fremantle. Why did it take us back out of Perth? There we go. Okay, Duke of York has been destroyed. Or the Dukes of York have been destroyed. Alright, Amazon's running like a little bitch, so Chatham is the next target on the chopping block. Let's go, guys. We're gonna do this. Hoorah! Not quite Australian. Ah, well. I probably got weapons still firing. Clear fleet target. Chase them. Excellent. Okay. Alright, what's our ETA, guys? Three hours? Yeah, 3 hours. Okay. So, we got the Vanguard, we got the Hood, we got the two Dukes of York. We got the Chatham coming up now. We're going to see if it's able to put up more of a fight. I have a sneaking suspicion that this one might potentially be an actual gunship, which means this will be a little bit on the dangerous side. But I don't know. It could also be a missile boat. Although I don't think we've seen anything that I don't think we've seen missile volleys that indicate that it is a missile boat. Thermal strength of 1280. 15 kilotons. Yeah, that's about right. Alright, we're closing in. We're actually in green ant range on the Chatham. Almost. Like, we're within range, but... oh, something's happening. Oh, production cycle. Okay. Picked up their active, and that means... hey, where's our tech? Oh, right, we're doing the power plant for the Lightning Dragon. So that's going to take a little while. Like, one more? Yeah. Let's just shift this into the 7th, if you can. Okay. I just want to make sure that it gets done this production cycle. Alright, so let's keep on moving, close in quick, Galasite shortage on Australia, where is our cargo Brisbane, you guys should be, okay, they're only 20 days out, and they have 1700 Galasite, okay, good. What galasite do we have on Brisbane at the moment? Okay, no, that's fine. Up at 20% manufacturing efficiency, which is great. We're still losing people, but making progress. As we get more, the manufacturing sector drops, but... does it drop or does it go up? No, it goes up. No, it doesn't. It drops. Goes up to service industries. But there is a little bit of a sweet spot. Whereas agriculture drops, service climbs, but then manufacturing kind of has a bit of a peak. Anyway. We're not doing that this episode. We're hunting precursors. We're going to see if this Chatham... is going to be a bit more of a challenge than the last ships. I do also just want to point out real quick that yes, I am powering through these precursors as if they were nothing, but this is only because I'm at a reasonable tech and I am have also prepared pretty reasonably against this type of threat. If you're not prepared, if you don't have the right ships, if you don't have the right gear, precursors are a serious threat. Especially really early on, because, if nothing else, just because of their level of E-War. It is a hazard, it is a danger, they... can destroy your fleets if you are not careful. So that is something that you do need to be aware of. So just because I'm walking all over them does not mean that you should treat them lightly. Alright. How are we doing? Why are we not following these guys? We just landed on top of them, didn't we? Yep, we did. Okay. Well, open fire. Fire with everything. Who's having problems with the escort? Oh, you know what it is? It might be these guys. Okay, we're gonna set these guys that way. And protect the destination. Okay. There's some kind of escort waffery going on. Well, Chatham's not a gunship. I don't know what it is, but it's definitely not a gunship. Otherwise, we would have been shot by now. Bang! Railguns, 24 damage hits from lasers. Wow, this thing's a beast! 8 layers of armor. Attempted to ram. Okay, so whatever. I gotta find out what the hell this is. Hang on, I gotta find out what the hell this is. Alright. Precursor. It's gonna be this thing. It's a jump cruiser. It's got Qs. Ah, so it was launching missiles. So it is a missile ship. It was launching missiles at us. I'm not sure what it was launching, but Oh well, while I'm here, these ones here will be the railguns firing. That one looks like a laser. Very weak for a laser. More likely this is a couple of railgun hits. This is the pattern of a 9 damage laser. But it's also the pattern of hang on. Three damage hit railgun. That's this kind of weird little square block. So if we do one here, two here. So, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, and then 1 here. Yeah, so 2 hits here, here, and then here. And that's the pattern that we ended up with. And then 1 here, 1 here. So, yeah. But these ones here, these big, deep ones, these will be the laser. So, you can see here, this one probably also includes a railgun hit as well. Because that pattern doesn't line up with the laser and the railgun. But there's definitely a laser here and here. These two at least have a laser involved somewhere. Just that depth is just a little bit excessive. Interestingly enough, we didn't actually break any components. Next salvo will probably be different. They are attempting to ram, which is a problem. If it hits, we're not going to have a fun time. But another 3 points of damage did hit it. So let's go have a look what kind of damage we dealt with it to it now. Armor status, you can see that it has chunked through a fair amount of extra armor. Five and nine, we should be seeing destruction on the next one. Or at least pretty significant damage. 3 more hits from the railguns. Attempted to ram. Yep. that you can see how the damage has penetrated further. We still haven't actually, even though we've broken the armor in a few places, we haven't actually landed any hits in those holes. So we haven't actually broken any components just yet. Hopefully it doesn't ram us in the meat before then. But we do have twice the speed advantage, so hopefully it won't. 3 more damage. Let's compare. There we are. And we knocked out a missile launcher. Alright. Next one. Ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-boom. Yeah, that's gonna hurt. This one's gonna hurt. Alright, let's check the update. Big holes. Lots of damage. That is a lot of damage. What's left on it? Jump drives knocked out. Magazines are gone. Engines are almost gone. Active search sensor is gone. Point defense gone. Missile launcher almost gone. Half of its EWAR suite is gone. Still got the ECM, unfortunately, which is super annoying. So yeah, all right. So it should be dying pretty soon. Maybe one or two more salvos of railguns. There's one. No, the engines are pretty much gone now. There's like one left. Active sensor is gone. Yeah, one more. Yeah, there's basically nothing of it left. And there it goes. Bang. Destroyed. Okay. So, that is pretty much almost the entire fleet wiped out. All that's left now is to go after those Amazons. And we do actually have the speed. So, I'm going to give the order, but we are pretty much out of time. So, that's going to have to be it. And next episode, we're going to finish these bastards off. So, thank you for watching, and I'll see you next time.